Hi everybody, I am Taryn and this is Verf. Today I'm gonna show you some new parameters. Yeah, I have added some new stuff. And that is a bristle count for our bristle brushes. So you can change the amount of bristles a brush has. And a bristle size. Bristle? Bristle! Did I say that more often? A bristle size, so you can change the size of your bristles. Ta-da! Very thin bristles, super thin bristles, super fat bristles. If I say that more often, I don't know, something's gonna happen with me. Alright, so, and you know, this is our standard bristle brush number 2. And number 3 is the bristle brush that has the continuous randomness, like so, and that really slowly but surely becomes my favorite brush again, because when you turn down the bristle count and increase the bristle size, you get these neat splotches. Now with the fluids on, it looks pretty wild, but with the fluids lesser, you get these nice kind of like one of the dapples, or what you would call that, I don't know. And they are very useful for many, many things. And of course, you can still smear with that and average with that, and all the usual, of course. So, I'm smearing around. So, there's that, and then there's the fact that your settings for the bristle count and size are stored with the brush you were using. So now I have these settings for brush number 3. If I go to brush number 2, I have whatever settings I was setting for this one. Now eventually I promise I'm gonna make a nice settings interface where you can actually customize your brushes and all the settings of the brushes, and most certainly even more settings that I still have to come up with, including also a new brush system that I was thinking about, and I can't wait, but it's gonna be a little bit of a bigger enterprise to make that happen. But for now, this is that part of the deal here, and they get stored with a brush. So that's very, very useful. You will find out if you try it. You will find out very quickly how very useful that can be. So with a very little count, you get all kinds of funny stuff. I mean, but with the fluids on, you get also very wild effects that way. Like I'm saying, the brush number 3 is really slowly but surely becoming my favorite for fun stuff like that. But also, of course, in less abstract contexts, which I might actually get to show you now if I move on. And moving on means, let me go back to brush number 2. So, turn the fluids down a little bit. Why? I don't know. There. All right. The build-up. The build-up parameter now is to control how much material each stroke puts on the canvas. So right now this is kind of somewhat how it used to be, and I can crank this all the way up, and then we get a lot of material. And you can crank it all the way down, and at that point no new material is added to the canvas. That means what happens right now is it puts color down and then shifts the existing material around. Like if you turned the fluids all the way down to 0, you would see that it just adds color. So it's almost like as if, you know, your molding paste or whatever that would be had dried, and you can brush over that. Now, however lightly you want to, you can still control the color amount with opacity, and you do all that sort of stuff. But you can also still use shift and smudge the paint around, so that doesn't go away, because it's all still on the same layer. So that way, it's another way, for example, to do like the glazing, as I was asked about earlier at some point. So you can do that, and then glaze if you wish, carefully, like so. This is brush number one. It's just an ordinary soft brush, but it's great for these kind of colorizations that are, you know, just on some areas, however you like that, however you want that. But this build-up parameter has, turns out to have a very curious side effect. I'm gonna add a new layer right now. I'm gonna turn the build-up a bit higher, and let's make some, I don't know, some ball or something like that. There you go. Doesn't matter, some form. I'm gonna erase around this real quick. Count up. Oh, there. Sure. Ah, yeah, opacity, that's why. So, let's say I have a very hard form here, like that. So with a build-up still high, you know, you keep painting on the canvas. But if I put the build-up to zero, no new material is added as I brush. So where there is no material, no color will be added. But where there is material, color will be added. So it's effectively like a auto mask type of thing for whatever shape you have. And so you can do these very simple ways of doing shading and such, and manipulate your shapes. But what is really interesting here is if you do have even like some, let me add a bit material, build up again, some feathered stuff going on. Let's just make some, you know, nonsense here. This all feathers out, maybe with a bit of fluids, why not? Maybe with a bit of more fluids, there you go. Ooh, yeah, that's wild. All right. Oh, with my favorite brush. It's just weird. All right, so now you have these very complex feathery outlines. You can just turn the build up to zero and then can resume, let me turn the fluids to zero. Then you can resume to just color that lightly if you wanted to. And it will only leave color where there's material. So that's a very pleasant way of working, you know, you don't have to plan out for your shapes, you know, to make alphas or masks or anything like that. It's automatically happening right away, like that. And I think it's kind of neat. And yeah, I'm being perfectly honest here, I really, that was not planned, it just turned out to be kind of cool. Funny side effects. Why not? It's a gift, a free gift. Da-da-da-da-da-da. Yeah, so it's really interesting to work that way. So there's that. And while I have some wacky stuff going on here, let me go back on the other layer and turn the glossiness down. And bring the bump up. No, it's okay. Let's leave it like this. I would like to show you some of the lighting stuff, because I don't think I was showing much of that yet. Because you can move the light source around, you know. Like so. So holding down shift and using the cursor keys moves the light source around in two dimensions. But using page down and page up moves the light source in and out of the canvas. See? So you can actually, especially on abstract paintings, you can use that quite well to for your design, however you want this to look. Of course you can control the bump height, you know, immense you want the bump to be, how structured. And here's the other thing, you can change the color of the light. So you pick the color you like for the light and hit L, and then this is your light color. This is kind of a funny way of doing also some kind of post-processing if you wanted to, you know, tint the whole image however you like. So that's the color of the light source, but you also have an ambient color. And let's pick another color here. With shift L, it changes the ambient lighting. Ta-da! So, it's actually rather just like a direct light straight down. I figure it's better than some overall illumination. Like general brightness would be dull, I think. So that way some shadows are kept as well. Yeah, so also you can use that, for example, temporarily if you wanted to, to actually turn off all the lighting. So I turned the light color to black, hit L, and the ambient color to white, go all the way white, and shift L, and then you get this. And also this way, also of course you can use that to tint your image however you like. Pick the color and shift L. Yep, there's that. Or you know, you can carefully fade in lighting like that. Just make a little bit of very dark light source, but a bright ambient light. And you can get some very nice effects that way. So you can still move the light around, of course. So that's just some other ways of working in Verve, which are, I think, kind of fun. Yeah, especially sometimes it's weird, especially when you have played around with the lighting and then you go ahead and manipulate stuff and it all still flows and it is a surreal feeling. Surreal, yes, it's a surreal feeling. There you go. Yeah. All that stuff. All the jazz. Yeah. And I changed the brushes a tiny little bit, the whole logic of it, so that you can very easily make very hard kind of, see, very obvious kind of strokes. Previously, I was too worried about actually the paint buildup, ironically, and I made them too mild. So now that's really strong, and you can very quickly make these kind of curious things. I did mention that I like brush number three. That's really fun. A smaller brush size, and we can make little fur things. Is that furry? I don't know. I sound like I don't know. I'm talking to a child here, and then I make this. I don't know. Maybe it's childish enough to fit my voice. Anyway, so there you go. So these are the new, some of the new things in Verve, and I made a whole bunch of fixes too, so that it should hopefully work a little better on machines I don't know of. Oh, that's so terrible. Yeah, at some point I gotta, depending on how, you know, how things go, how the reactions are, hopefully I at some point can consider to take all of this to the next level. I don't know. I mean, this is no hint or anything like that, but yeah. If it was really a serious development, then I would have to get all kinds of machines to test it out and all that. Which scares me, but I'd still, you know, why not? I'd be happy. Anyway, there you go. So the latest, greatest in Verve. Strange stuff. Yeah. Oh, also the PNGs now do not have an alpha anymore because the alpha was redundant, and they clamp properly, so you don't get any kind of bad artifacts or stuff that you don't want. It's just all now taken care of. That looks a bit weird down here, doesn't it? What is this? I don't know. Must have done some dark strokes at some point. Huh? Curious. Nice though. I don't mind. I don't mind. It has a mind of its own. I like to let Verve make some decisions every now and then too. Why not? Although I should investigate. That seems to be brand new. Anyway. Alright, so enough for now, I think. Yeah, hope you get to try it out and get to have some fun with it too. And I'll see you soon. Bye for now.